Hi everyone, Carol here at Oak House Journals, and as always, a big warm welcome from me. So, week 25 of the 52 tag project, and I've got my bits and bobs here in front of me that I'm planning to use. I have an idea in mind, but I'm going to work very close to what Anne suggested in terms of a tag that is woven. So for anybody that saw my previous video when I made this for one of my journals, I made a mistake when I was making the frame. So I started again, and this is, sorry, I've got a piece of fluff on there. This is the mistake I made, and it was because I didn't like this dark black stitching round the outside. Now, if you remember from that video, if you saw it, this is a double page that I've glued together, and then as you can see, I have stitched it, but inside here is a piece of acetate, and my idea there was to kind of give some more substance or reinforce these two pages when they were glued together. So what I thought I would do this time round is I would use up this piece, because the papers are out of the journal that I'm creating, and I want to keep the same sort of colour theme and tones going. So what I thought I would do is I've got two size 8 Ranger Manila tags here. And what I thought I would do with these is I would glue one of these onto the front of this page here, so that my black stitching is hidden on the left hand side. And then I'm going to cut away all the way around the outside, so that this becomes a, if I can open that up, a flap in my journal or a page. So by hiding the stitching down this side, that will make me happy. By cutting it round here, that will give me a bit of interest in my journal, because it will be tag shaped for this page. This page will be just as normal behind, and it will also cut away this stitching. Plus the fact that it's got the acetate sandwiched between these two brown pieces of handmade paper, and with this glued on top, I'm going to have a nice sturdy base to work on to do my weaving. Now, there's going to be no aperture like I did on this one. It will be purely weaving on top of the tag as Anne did. But my stitches, obviously from the threads that I'm going to weave through, will show on this side. So what I'm going to do when I've finished my weaving, I'm going to use my other tag and I'm going to glue it on the reverse, so that it will hide my reverse stitching and give me a base that I can work on for another project here. And then obviously this will be stitched down the centre in my journal as part of the signature, and then I will have two other pages that I can play with as well. So that's what I'm thinking. So my first plan really is to actually cut these down slightly, because I know when I did this one how long it takes to fill up that space, and these tags are going to be wider, but certainly not much shorter as they are in length. So what I think I will do is I will cut them down from the angled edges and re-angle them to make the tags a lot narrower, which again will add interest to the journal, so I'm hoping. So that's my plan. I've lifted out some threads here that I'm planning to use. I've got this Steph Francis textured selection. This is textured selection colourway number 26, if you're interested, and again I'll put the link in the description box down below. But I love the colours. I wanted something, because this is going to be my background and I'm not covering it with anything, I wanted something fairly soft and muted and quite pretty, but I also needed something that would tone in with these colours here. So this I thought would be a really good idea, because I've got loads of, if I can get it open for you, take that label off. I've got loads of different threads that I can use. There's chenille here, there's perle. And what I particularly like, although I'm not a glitzy metallic kind of girl, is there's a metallic thread in here that I think will pick up the beige colour on here, but also give a little bit of a lift. So I'm planning to use that. I'm also planning to use this. This was some Avril yarn that I got. So this, as you can see, is almost like a rickrack ribbon, but it isn't, it's wool. So that'll give me a nice texture. I've got this lovely stuff, which I used a lot in the other one that I did over there. And this is like a very, very delicate wool. And I think that'll be nice for giving it some texture. This I've got is a really soft Avril twine with some flags in it. So I think that will be nice as well. And similarly here, this is another Avril twine, when I can find the end. And this really has got some true velvet flags in it. So again, I thought I would use that. And if I find I need a little bit more toning down to pick up this shade, I can pick out some threads out of this skein that I've got here. Now this is a House of Embroidery. I think it's a perle cotton, and I'm just trying to think what weight it will be. I think it's an 8 weight. It looks like an 8 weight to me. So that's got tones of blue, beige, cream in it. So that might be good. So that's my plan, and I'm going to go away and set things up and get myself started. And I'll give you some pictures along the way, and I'll be back. Okay. So my base is all prepared now. As you saw, I cut down my tag. I decided to add a bit of interest by stitching round the outside. It's just glued onto the backing here, but I decided I'd like to reinforce that. So I've stitched around the outside. I've put my threads across. This is some fine waxed bookbinding thread that I had, which really wasn't much good for bookbinding, or I don't think it was. It was a little bit too weak. So I thought this would be ideal for this project. I took the washer off the back to try and make it as smooth as I could. I did another tag to match the one on the front, and I'm just going to do the same. Just going to take this washer off, or reinforcer, off the back when it wants to come. Not coming away clean, but that doesn't matter because it's going to be hidden. So that will go on the reverse of my page and look like so when I've finished it. So the weaving will be on that side, and some sort of decoration at a later date will be there, stitched in here. As you saw, I reduced the size of this page as well. So these will be in the journal, but will be smaller. So it's coming along nicely now. So I'm just going to pop that one to one side. My darning needle wasn't wide enough to go across all my threads here. So I've got a glover's needle, which is for leather work, and that's going to be wide enough. As you can see, it's got a nice blunt end to it. And I've also opened out my skein here. So I've got five different variety of threads. So I'm just going to make a start now and decide which thread I want to start with. And I think I will probably go for this one, which is one of the perlays. So I'm just going to separate that out. There we go. Put my other threads to one side, somewhere where they're not going to get tangled. And thread up my needle and get going. So I'm having a stop along the way. As you can see, a scene of devastation on my desk here. I've got my fork because that was invaluable last time for just pushing my threads down onto my piece. And I've also got tweezers for the occasional short piece of thread that I need to pull through. And as you can see, I'm building up the texture. I'm keeping it very light and fluffy, and I'm really liking how it looks at the moment. And I'm keeping my ends here fairly long. I'm going to trim those in line at the end. So I've decided not to use this one. It was too heavy, I thought, on here. And I'm trying to keep it, as I say, quite light and fluffy. I've got one layer of this metallic thread. It's like a tube shot through with some gold metallic thread. It's quite nice, but I've only used a tiny little bit in there. I have used this, but I used it, as you probably saw, just to tie round. I think these are my warp or weft threads, I can't remember now, but to tie round here. It doesn't look particularly good when you thread it through, because you don't get much of a look actually, but doing that, it looks quite nice on that one, so I might try it again. The one I really did like was this big bundle of Avril twine here that I've got. I've wound off a little bit on to a shorter spool or a smaller spool because this was getting tangled. So this was a 50 gram ball, so I've got a card to one side here that I will be winding it on. And similarly with all the Steph Francis textured selection 25 bundle that I had, that big skein, I've wound these onto smaller cards or smaller spools, and that one was included as well, because they were getting tangled. I should have done that straight away. I'm loving how this one looks. It's got a slight shimmer to it, but it actually will fray up. If I hold, there's my needle with a little bit left on, I can fray it up quite nicely, and it looks really nice. So I'm having a ball here, so I'm just going to carry on and I will be back. Yeah, off I go. So I've finished all my weaving now, and this is where I've got to. I still need to trim my edges here. I'm not going to trim them really close, but I am going to trim them down a little bit. And this is my tag, obviously, to go on the back, like so. So I put a little bit of fluff up here from some of the weaving, just to see what it looked like. I'm a little bit unsure about here. It doesn't seem to sit quite right with me at the moment. I will have a look and see what it looks like once I've trimmed down the size, to see if it sits any better with me. But if not, I'm thinking maybe I might put another hole there and another one here. Whether I weave anything through it or not, I don't know. Or I might just leave it like that for a bit of detail. That's kind of up in the air at the moment. What I have done, though, is I have lifted out some seed beads in various colours that I thought might tie in with this, because I just think it would be lovely to have a few little beads dotted in and out. And I also might do a bit more of the flag work using this. I put a strip in and then pulled it out because the colour just wasn't right. But as little tiny flags, it doesn't seem too bad. So I might put some more of those on when I've put my seed beads in. Now, this one looks really green. If I hold it up to the camera, you'll see it looks really green against the pale blue here. But actually, if I lift out these beads, they don't look too bad. So there's a mix in here, some with like a blue core to the glass, so they might be quite nice to use. So I'm thinking about using some of those, but definitely I like these. Now, these are lovely, and the nice thing about these are that I've got various sizes of beads tucked away in here. And true to form, only the big ones have come out. But trust me, there are a few in here that are different sizes, which might look nice on here. I've also put a couple of tiny little pearls on here to see what they look like, and they look quite nice. So that's what I'm going to do next. Trim my edges and then decide what I want to do up here. And then certainly I will be adding some seed beads, and I'll show you some pictures along the way and then show you the finished tag or finished piece when it's all done and dusted. So this is more or less the finished piece. I finished my weaving, as you know, and I hope you can just make out I've just gone all over, adding tiny mixed sized or various sized beads, and they're kind of tucked in everywhere. So there's one here, some have been pearls, there's a couple of big ones there, tiny little pearl up here, tiny, tiny little seed bead there. And when I got this colour out, it was just perfect, so I just stuck with that, added a couple of the little tiny pearls on to pick up the whites, and there are a couple of tiny, tiny little sequins. I'm not sure if That might just catch the light. But anyway, that's my finished piece. I've trimmed the edges, as you can see, but not so that I've got pristine lawn edges. I've kind of left them fairly loose. So I'm happy with that. I've made a couple of decisions since I last turned on the camera. And the first one is I wasn't happy with what was going on up here. I got my brads out, not my brads, my eyelets out to have a look to see what colours I'd got and to see what I liked, because what I thought I would do is put an eyelet on either side and maybe do a little bit of horizontal weaving up there. But I'm happy. Once I've put my eyelets in, I'm quite happy with how it looks. Now, at first I thought that I would leave the reinforcer on and then perhaps use that one. But for me, that looks a bit top heavy still. So I went with one of the little ones. These are We Are Memory Keepers eyelets. And I've got two colours in here actually. So I've got that colour. And again, I like that. It kind of keeps it nice and delicate. But I'm just going to swap it over and put the slightly lighter green shade I've got. And for me, that is perfect. It makes it even softer still. So I'm going to go with that. And I'm not even going to put any embellishment or fibres out of the top. I'm just going to leave it because I like the look of that. It looks nice and delicate to me, which is the effect that I wanted. So I'm just going to put that to one side. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the other card that we cut to size on the other side, and true to form, I'm doing it on my felt mat, which is not meant for gluing on. Honestly, this is one of those New Zealand wool mats that they're supposed to be for quilters, I believe, to iron on, but I have to say, oh, I absolutely love mine, and I use it all the time for sewing on when I, if I'm not sitting in the lounge watching television and sewing, then I use it all the time. I'm just putting on some art glitter glue. Please excuse the state of my tube or the label on my tube. I've tried covering it several times, as you can see. It's got very, very cracked, and I do wash it, but it's got very kind of cracked, and I have tried covering it, but it doesn't last very long. So just put that on top. I'm just going to reverse it over. Still leaving this reinforcer on the back, but on the reverse side. But on the reverse side of this particular card, you will have seen that I actually took it off because it's going to be quite thick. There we go. I'm just going to press it down from the reverse. Okay. Sorry, went into a little chat about art glitter glue and bottles, didn't I? Sorry about that. Honestly, I probably haven't seen enough people today. So that's my eyelet going in there. Got my nice. Just going to give that another quick press around the outside. And there we go, that's my finished piece. So as I say, I will do some decoration on this at a later date. And similarly with those two pages, I've brought over my journal. As you know, it's all in pieces, this one, because this was one of the Raining Woods journals that I took apart with the intention of adding pieces to it. It's going to be a much bigger journal. At the end of the day, it's obviously going to come out to here, maybe a bit taller. This was the original cover, as you can see here. So I've got one or two pieces that I've been doing and tucked away in here. Yeah, that goes that way. I was thinking, oh, I'm not sure which way that goes. So I was kind of thinking that one might go there, and I might edge it up to the page, edge of the page to hide that stitching. So that one's going to go in there. You've seen all of these, everybody, I'm sure, if you've been watching some of my videos. Nothing new. Not sure I like that one, but never mind. That was my little attempt at a little flower. That was another one. That's my mossy bank one. That's a bit chunky to go in here, but never mind. Oh, love this one. Always have done. Let me just put that one straight. So as you can see, I've got all sorts tucked away in here. I'm just kind of letting it come together organically. You might not have seen that one. That's a flower, as you can see. It's a dandelion that I wanted to have a go at embroidering a dandelion. And I thought the colours might go well on this rusted fabric because it's got tones of yellow in. So that's that one. I will be backing it on. The reason I've put them in various slots is because the handmade paper, I quite like the background. So this one will be going on that just to keep it looking fairly fine. This one again is another dimensional one, which I love. Never done anything like this before, and I was so pleased how this one came out. So, sorry, I'm digressing. Anyway, so I'm kind of thinking, let me just show you what I'm thinking. So let's find a page. Probably something like that. So I'm thinking that this one will go somewhere like that in the journal. Obviously, it's going to have to go somewhere that isn't quite so giving me such a chunky spine, but I'm thinking it will kind of go like that in the journal, so it'll be flipping like that, and then the reverse will be wherever the reverse is. The reverse will be slightly smaller pages, a couple of those, like so. So there's my finished piece for this week, and I have to say I enjoyed doing it. When I did my weaving one, this one belongs in the journal as well. When I did that one, I had so much fun doing that. And as you can see, this is a lot more textured with papers and twigs and all sorts. So it was really nice to do a soft, fluffy, fluffy one for in here. I nearly did pieces of book script and just purely that. But then I thought I was so enjoying sewing this week with the aqua tones for the ocean journal, ocean tags, that I thought it would be nice to carry on with this colour combo. And as I say, that textured selection 25 colourway from Steph Francis, absolutely lovely, really is gorgeous. So thank you so much, everybody, as always, for watching and bearing with me. If you've made it to the end of the video, congratulations, you deserve a medal. Have a lovely, lovely day, and whatever you're doing, have a smile and enjoy your crafting. Take care. Bye.